Okay, just counting down for the close as we step into this long weekend, and it's been not all that disappointing, but remember, it's a long weekend, so you don't know what sort of cues we're going to wake up to on Tuesday morning when the market does resume trading. But today we've done okay. We're pretty much closing around where we started off in trade. Did fall below the 9,000 mark and then seen a 50-odd point recovery coming in from the lows. 90.41 on the Nifty futures, that's how we've shut shop. The breath as well isn't all that bad as we were at the lows of the day. We managed to recover some lost ground, but still we're going in favor of the declines. The biggest sectoral laggard today has got to be finance. That's almost gotten clobbered by about almost 4-odd% or so. Not much of movement coming in for cap goods, banking. They've all closed in the red. FMCG for that matter, real estate as well has been a sector loser today. And for that matter, power and metals as well have gone home with red ticks. It's clearly financial. So starting off with Bajaj Finserv, which lost about 5% today on the futures. Axis Bank, roughly a 5% cut there as well. HDFC down, Bajaj Finance down about almost 4.6%. ICICI Bank goes home with a 4% cut. And then metals, because of the fresh escalations of tensions between what's going on Hong Kong as well as China and how US has retaliated to that, you are seeing metals see a fresh wave of selling. Also remember, most of Asia has bled, especially China as well as Hong Kong have closed in with deep gashes. And that's exactly how Europe as well has kick-started trade. So Hindalco, Tata Steel, these have all been significant losers today. Even from within the broader markets, a PFC, Ujjivan, Shriram Transport Finance, Indiabulls Housing, Equitas. Equitas, in fact, lost about almost 7% there. So these have been your big losers today. Add to that an ICICI True Life also, which has lost about 4.5%. On the flip side, Z, M&M, NIT Technologies, ACC, Shri Cement, Infosys, which led by about almost 3%, Britannia, which goes home a winner, 2% higher there, and Asian Paints and TCS and Maruti, which have also had some green ticks. But Avan, what about the newsmakers today?
Well, it's clearly been those banks that have been in the limelight in today's trading session, and for the most part, as you flagged off, have been beaten pretty badly out of shape. Ditto for the Nifty Bank. Do remember the finance minister as well going ahead and defending that 20,000 crore rupees stimulus, and you had all of the news that filtered in. Reliance Industries as well, as Mukesh Ambani has now bagged his fifth check that we've seen. So it's 11,300 crore rupees for a PE giant investing a 2.3% stake into the company. So that too has been another stock that has been in focus in today's trading session. The entire aviation packet, and we continue to monitor what's happening on that front. Remember, the latest is that the DGCA has approved the schedule for 2,800 flights across airlines till the 30th of June. So that continues to be a space that we're tracking. But I just want to map out how the broader universe has shaped up. It's down about 0.7% for the mid and the small caps. So pretty much in line with the frontliners in today's trading session. And there have been a whole host of stocks that have managed to buck the general trend. So I just want to flag those off. Z Entertainment, take a look at something like Quest Corp. That's done quite well today. You've got a Lemon Tree Hotels, despite all of the concerns regarding hospitality, because that sector's been beleaguered out of shape. Delta, ditto, you've got SpiceJet, India Cements, as well as Tata Power and Philips Carbon. They're managing to hold out in today's trading session. But names like BSC, Mahindra Holidays, PSC, Credit Access, AU Small, they've all had a very rough run in today's trading session. Well, for the week gone by then, it's been the third straight weekly decline. For the month of May, we've been down nearly 8%. The Nifty Bank as well has declined three straight weeks on the trot. And in the month of May has seen a massive underperformance, nearly 20% on that index. While the broader end of the markets this week have fallen nearly 2%, you have seen quite a bit of alignment with the frontliners and the broader markets. The volatility index as well declining for the second week on the trot, down 7 out of the last 8 weeks. Sectors like FMCG have managed to advance, led by IT. Energy continues to decline. Autos gaining for the second straight week, and IT as well has managed to snap the two-week losing streak and holding out in the green. Names like ITC, M&M, Cipla have posted the best week in the last 1 month, so those have been massive gainers. Whereas you've got the likes of Indiabulls Housing, Mahindra Finance, as well as ICICI, SBI, and they continue to decline. So that pretty much wraps up today's trading session as we ended up at 9,039, 260 points down on the Sensex. We've got a truncated week, but it's going on the Sensex.